This lifting up of the spirit is surely the way that men have found themselves transformed. Yet this is no success formula. Though by so caring for something quite beyond myself, I can be made superhuman. I shall never gain even magnanimity if self-nobility is my aim. There is the paradox of perfection. He who loves himself shall lose himself. That, the most dreaded threat to the ego, is the highest promise to the true self. Let us listen to Cleanthes, the second founder of Stoicism, which for the first time taught men of the West that they were indeed all brethren, children of one all-embracing life. This is Cleanthes' own prayer. From it we may learn how her heroic soul addressed himself to that will in whom is our peace. It is an act of aspiring submission and inspiring acceptance. Lead thou me, God, law, reason, motion, life, all names for thee alike are vain and hollow. Lead me, for I will follow without strife, or if I strive, still must I humbly follow. But may we never hope to be borne on this vast current that pours forth from and returns to the height of freedom, the fount of life, the source of power. From the far east and the dawn of thought comes this guide, speaking in a few masterly lines, both of the moving mystery, the ever-flowing way in which we live and move and have our being, and also of the way in which we may intentionally move in perfect rhythm with that unhurried but irresistible flow. The way that lies deeper than all ways was never wrought, yet through it all works are done. This, the only true way, is never closed. Everywhere you will find it running, therefore it cannot be defined, because our eye seeks for it and finds it not. It is called invisible. Because the ear listens, yet cannot hear it is said to be inaudible. Because the hand would touch it and finds nothing, men say, there is nothing there. Because it is so unanswerable, we call it absurd. Here, though, are the three ways that can lead us into this, the way of all ways. The first is pity, the second is frugality, the third is anonymity. For only he that has compassion can be brave, only he that never hoards can be staunchless, only he that never asserts himself can be the leader of all. Today our bravery is not based on pity, nor our profusion on unpossessiveness, nor our eminence on self-effacingness, and this is death. But pity cannot advance without conquering, or guard without delivering. Heaven arms with pity those whom it would not see destroyed.